Thank you. Please be seated. Inga mana, inga reo, inga hoa fa. Tēnā koutou, Vice Chancellor, Pro Chancellor, Council members, special guests, staff, graduands, family and friends of graduands. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of Council members and staff of the University. In particular, I welcome our guest speaker, Professor Michael McWilliams. I also acknowledge the recent passing of Dr. Merimeri Penfold, who was a long-term member of the University of Auckland staff, a distinguished Māori scholar, and for many years, the kuia at our graduation ceremonies. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland for the purpose of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. This week, we will be conferring and awarding more than 6,500 on some 6,478 students in person and in absentia. At this ceremony, 455 students will graduate in person and 131 students will graduate in absentia. I will be assisted by Mr. Peter Kiley, the Pro-Chancellor. This is a happy and memorable occasion for you, the graduands, as well as your families and friends who have supported you during your studies. We congratulate you all. Equally, your achievement brings pleasure and satisfaction to the academic and professional staff of the university who have played their part in your success. Capping is a time for celebration. The graduation procession today brought academic flavour and colour to the streets of Auckland, and in this ceremony, you will experience the pomp and tradition befitting your well. Over a period of 130 years, the University of Auckland has become a comprehensive, research-led university with a strong international reputation. Today, there are more than 40,000 students and 5,000 staff. Moreover, we are New Zealand's largest research organisation with one-third of the country's externally rated world-class researchers. Within New Zealand, we also have a strong commitment to Māori education. Of all the Māori degree graduates in New Zealand each year, 25% come from just one institution, the University of Auckland. For Pacifica graduates, the number is more like 40%. The quality and international reputation of the university are fundamentally driven by the achievements of its people, and last year was an exceptional one for our academic staff, who won almost every form of recognition available to them in New Zealand. In July, Professor Alison Jones and Associate Professors Bryony James and Katha Simpson won National Tertiary These awards mean that for 11 of the last 12 years, our teachers have been recognised as amongst the very best in the country. In November, engineers, distinguished Emeritus Professor John Boys and Professor Grant Kovic, won the Supreme Award at the Prime Minister's Science Prizes Awards for their work on inductive power transfer. Dr. Ben O'Brien from the Auckland Bay Engineering Institute won the McDiarmid Emerging Scientist Prize for his groundbreaking work on artificial muscles. And Dr. Susie Wiles from Molecular Medicine and Pathology Our staff also excelled at the 2013 Royal Society of New Zealand Awards, winning 4 major medals. The most notable was Distinguished Professor Dame Anne Salmon from Māori Studies, winning the Society's highest honour, the Rutherford Medal. This was awarded for her eminent work on Māori social structures and interactions within the Pacific world, the European world, and on European exploration in the Pacific. She was also named Kiwi Bank New Zealander of the Year for 2013. And then yesterday, it was announced that of the 6 national centres of research excellence to be funded by the government, by the University of Auckland, and we will be a partner in the other 2. This is an outstanding achievement by our leading scientists, and I congratulate the directors, the teams, and all those who have contributed to this success. These achievements reflect the outstanding quality, not only of our academic staff, but also of the students who work with them and the many professional staff who support them. A key part of our challenge for the future, and one that is clearly reflected in our is to continue to invest in a community of highly accomplished staff and students. An important element of that investment is ensuring that our teaching facilities are of the highest quality. To this end, the University of Council completed in 2013 the purchase of the former Lion Breweries site in Newmarket as the basis for a new campus, which will be integrated with the existing City and Grafton campuses. Work is well underway on construction of the engineering research laboratories. These buildings represent an investment of approximately $88 million to support our engineering research and postgraduate teaching for the benefit of all New Zealand. We will occupy the first of the new facilities in July this year. Work has also begun on the new science tower on the corner of Wellesley and Simon Streets. This major construction project represents an investment of more than $300 million to upgrade science teaching and research and integrate the School of Psychology and the School of Environment into the main science precinct. This will in turn free up the Human Sciences Building for refurbishment as the centre of the arts faculty. Constant innovation is the cornerstone of a university such as ours. Innovative teaching and research is vital for long-term sustainable economic growth of our country and social cohesion of our nation. This has never been more so than in the testing times we face in the wake of the global recession, the Christchurch earthquakes, and the yet-to-be-defined effects of global warming. Universities equip graduates like you, not simply for the jobs of today, but for future careers not yet imagined in an ever-changing world. So as you graduate today, please reflect options available to you at this university. Reflect on the changes in technology you have already experienced in your lifetime, and remember that much of the technology you will use in your future work and career has yet to be developed or commercialised. I ask you to do this because we can never rest on our laurels, especially in a challenging and ever-changing world. Whatever path you follow as you go out into the world, I urge you as the alumni of New Zealand we rely on our graduates for support, moral, political and financial. Funding constraints are a perennial problem for New Zealand universities, who are being asked to do more and more with less and less each year. In fact, in these times, we should be spending more on universities, not less. So don't worry, we will be in touch with you, and when we do, please lend us your support. But that's enough of the substantial of a 21st century university with high aspirations, because today is your day, with the focus firmly on your achievement. At the ceremony, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. It is indeed a privilege to invite Professor Michael McWilliams to speak to us this afternoon. He is Professor Emeritus of Geological and Environmental Sciences and he has held for more than 35 years, and the Chief Executive of the Crown Research Institute, GNS Science. In his university position, Michael is a research scientist, mentor, teacher, and science communicator who has built an internationally recognised top 10 research program in isotype geoscience. He is the principal advisor and mentor to postgraduate students and postdoctoral scientists, and a consultant to 38 government science agencies, universities and technology companies and academic publishers. As GNS Science Chief Executive, he leads a team of 385 scientists, engineers, postdoctorals, students and support staff engaged in natural resources exploration and research as geothermal, mineral and petroleum, research in natural hazards geoscience, earthquakes, volcanoes, tsunami, hydrogeology research, and isotope and materials science. In previous positions, he has worked as Professor of Applied Physics and Director of the John DeLater Center of Isotope Research, and in several senior management positions with the Commonwealth Scientific and Industrial Research Organization. He also holds many directorships and advisory board positions. Michael, we look forward to your address.
Chancellor. Members of the university graduands, families, whānau, and friends. Look at you guys. Congratulations, you made it. You're about to be rewarded with an outstanding degree from an outstanding university. The best in New Zealand, the Vice Chancellor says. Yesterday's announcement, to which the Chancellor just referred, is evidence of that excellence. $210 million in six centers of research excellence was announced. Four of them here in Auckland, but all six this university is a participant in. That's a great position for this university to go forward in the future. Perhaps the reason I'm here today is that there are some who would say that I've had a reasonably successful career in science, and something about my story might be useful to you. Perhaps. Mostly I wanted to take a forward-looking view, though, because about 40 years ago I was sitting where you are now, and the world is a very, very different place than it is now. So, pose this question: what kind of a world are you headed into? Many organizations, example McKinsey or my former employer CSIRO in Australia, are working to map and try to understand what that world looks like and what the mega trends, what the most important trends might be that you guys will be facing. Those analyses consistently point to a series of global mega trends. Among them that I think are very important are personalization, mobility, and resource scarcity. The world will be increasingly personalized. In your lifetime, you'll be treated with drugs that are fine-tuned to your genome and designed to target exactly what it is that ails you at that time. As an example, This month, the scientists at the Queensland Brain Institute published a paper in the Proceedings of the National Academy. And they say they've discovered the possibility, anyway, of controlling the gene that is associated with fear in humans. If that's true, it would be quite useful. For example, perhaps the people at our Wilkins Center here could use this discovery to mute our fear of losing the Rugby World Cup. Your children will have a completely different university education than the one that you've just experienced. It'll have content and feedback that's tailored just to them and targeted in personalized ways. You and your children and the rest of the world become increasingly mobile and increasingly urban. And something you know already for sure, and the world is going to be increasingly challenged by resource scarcity, particularly in energy, in water, and in food, and their impact on the environment. Here, the rules of conventional market economics will be in effect, and you know how those work, and they'll continue to operate. But you know these things. You're well-equipped now to address these trends. We need you to be discovering things, developing things, communicating those ideas to government and to the people, set policy, create wealth, and protect the environment while you're at it. But you also know that the world is increasingly data-rich, sensor-rich, and network-rich, and the number of sensors, the amount of data, and the speed of networks connecting those sensors are growing at an unprecedented rate. I'd like to recommend a book to you that I've read recently. It's called The Second Machine Age, written by a couple of one-handed economists at MIT. This is my opportunity to throw in a joke about economists. I have lots of them. The one-hand economist reference is to President Truman, who famously said, "What this country needs is a set of one-handed economists, because on the one hand, the economists are saying this, and on the other hand, they're saying that." This book is called The Second Machine Age. In the first machine age, you're very familiar with, machines provided the power to take over the labor, the muscle power that people did at that time. But we're in the opening round of the second machine age, where computers and digital devices are doing for mental power what machines did formerly for muscle power in the first machine age. Second machine age has three important components. It's exponential, it's digital, and it's combinatorial. These are characteristics that are changing the world. The exponential part you know very well already. Many of you will know of Moore's law for semiconductor devices. You may have heard of Hendy's law about digital optical devices, where the doubling rate of pixels per dollar doubles about, say, every year. So that's not Sean Hendy, it's a different Hendy. For years, people have been saying that laws like that, Moore's law and the like, are ending, but they keep being proved wrong. We're not bending the laws of physics or chemistry, we're just getting better at using them and discovering new things. About 4 zettabytes of information will be created and replicated this year. A zettabyte is a billion terabytes, it's really big. 4 zettabytes is about what the net contains today. This creates huge opportunities with huge consequences. And this is a shout out to the stats majors who might be here. If I were starting a new career today, I'd embark on big data statistics. So if there's some of you out there, I think that's a good direction for you guys to be taken. But some of those 4 zettabytes are image data. I imagine you guys will be contributing to that today. That's a lot of selfies. But I want to give you a personal example. I grew up in a particularly unremarkable town called Rochester, New York, which was the home since 1888, I believe, of the Kodak company. When I was a kid, every second kid's parent worked for Kodak, and the ones who didn't work for Kodak worked for Xerox, and I think you're beginning to see the imaging connection there. In 2003, Xerox, it's about a little over a decade ago, this company had been around for 100 and some odd years, filed for bankruptcy. They had 64,000 employees at the time around the world. They filed for bankruptcy in 2012, There's about 9,000 employees now. They have to sell off all their intellectual property to maintain. They're afloat now, but it's a completely different company. Few people need film or chemicals or paper and that kind of stuff anymore. We need 2D and 3D printers, imaging devices, and display devices of that sort. Going back to Moore's law, this week in Germany, Sony introduced a new magnetic tape cartridge capable of holding 185 terabytes. That's just a number, but the record, the previous record was 35. Things are just happening very, very rapidly, as you well know. That development is really important because by 2020, we're going to need about 40 zettabytes of storage. We don't have that now. We're going to need it. People have been saying that the limit, like Moore's law, the limit for magnetic recording was reached long ago, and it's just not so. The Square Kilometer Array, of which New Zealand is a partner, it's a radio telescope project, is a remarkable big data challenge and opportunity in science. That array will produce data at the rate of 10 times the annual internet traffic today. Most of it will be noise, of course, but the challenge is you won't be able to store that information. Someone will have to design algorithms to look at that information on the fly and separate the signal from the noise. It's a huge opportunity. And just this week in New York, Chinese e-commerce group Alibaba is filing an IPO on the New York Stock Exchange. There are 500 million connected internet users in China at the moment. Their portals every day reach 100 million unique internet addresses, and their sales are more than eBay and Amazon combined. If you think about that as opportunities for companies in this country, these opportunities weren't there 5 or even 10 years ago. And this leads us to the second part, the digital. As you well know, the world's been digital for a long time, but just as it took a long time for the steam engine to really be useful in the Industrial Revolution, it's taken a while for us to get where we are now, but we really are on an exponential growth point. Digital copies of things are massless. They have essentially zero marginal cost of replication, and they can be distributed almost instantly. They're subject to different economic rules, driven by abundance, not scarcity. So supply and demand, the traditional economic models, don't work. So the traditional economists are going to have to throw up either both hands or one hand, depending on if they're one-handed economists. There's also a winner-take-all principle here in some of these digital businesses. Think about the last app you bought for your smartphone. It probably cost about the same as the second best app or the third best app, but you chose it probably because other people said it was the best one. And the next person will probably do the same thing. We're in a time when it's you've got to be great to survive, and second best probably isn't good enough. And finally, the world is combinatorial now. You know that novel and sometimes optimal solutions to new problems come from unexpected people and unexpected sources. Perhaps some of you have heard of a company called Inocentive. It's been around for about a decade. It's a crowdsourcing research organization. They connect people with problems that they can't solve with something like 300,000 people in 200 countries around the world. Crowdsourcing by this mechanism successfully solves about a third of the problems that people submit to them, and those are problems that the individuals themselves or their companies haven't been able to solve, so they put it out to Inocentive. Those solutions often come from people whose areas of expertise are far from the problem at hand. The more ideas you connect and the more people you combine, the more likely you are to have a breakthrough. And that leads me to my closing remark. I've been to a lot of graduation ceremonies and speeches in my life. In his graduation speech at Stanford in 2005, Steve Jobs of Apple Computer remarked that at this stage in your life, it's pretty easy to connect the dots looking backward, but you guys are living your life forward, not backward. So you need something as guidance. For me, if I take that backwards look, the things that were important to me were taking those chances that might seem really wild at the time, traveling a lot, most importantly, putting yourself where there's a constant flux of new people and ideas. That was the right thing for me, and I suggest that some of that might be the right thing for you. Steve said that because you live your life forward, though, you can't connect the dots that way. You have to trust in something that will connect the dots for you in the future. You've got to trust in something, your gut, destiny, karma, whatever. But have the courage to follow your heart and your intuition. They got you this far already, and they know what you truly want to become. The world is moving quickly. I tried to illustrate that previously. Life is a sprint between two events separated by an unknown period of time. All of you have your intellectual running shoes on now. Today you get a shiny new pair of shoelaces for those running shoes. None of us know where the finishing line is, but I hope you enjoy the race. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor McWilliams, for a most interesting and insightful address. Can you all join with me in thanking Professor McWilliams once more? This is a meeting of council and convocation of the university for a ceremony of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor, award the degrees and confer the diplomas stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Science, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Deputy Dean of the Faculty of Science, Professor Metzen, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Deputy Dean, I have the honour of presenting you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or the conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Science. To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Lian Yun Ma. Nielsen Ma. Taramikidzawa Abisha Machikairi. Chloe Amanda Mackey. Michael Jack McLean. Senior Scholar Science Yuki Makahara. Sean Ishwar Lee Mahendran. Asfin Mahmood. Therese Megan Saleh Malcolm. Eros James Maleli. Brenda Reedy Mamidi. Fatima Maksud. Oliver James Marino. Sam Marugi. Ryan James Marriott. Chloe Elise Marsh. Chloe May Marshall. Charlton J. Martin. Mara Andrea Gabriel Martinez. Amy Joy Polu Maslin Miller. Reisa Lena Matthias. Daniel Matthias. Manju Maxi. David Richard Fiora May. K. Connor Shea McAteer. Thomas Alexander McCartney. George Trevathan McCurdy Edmund. Elizabeth Alice McGlashan. Malcolm Eric McEwen. Andrew David McNeil. Fatin Fatia Nzan. Kylie William Gordon Meffin. Christine Alice Middendorf Carter. Candice Marie Miller. Florence Johanna Ross Mitchell. Laurie John Lee Mitchell. Natasha Jean Mitchell. Nur Akita Binti Mohammed Azar. Aaron Douglas Moller. Ronan Andrew Money. Madeline Rose Morey. Caleb Joshua Daniel Moses. Anant Aaron Mudalia. Melissa Kathleen Mullaney. Lauren Charlotte Muldrew. Lauren Kylie Murray. Jack Suleiman Minette Johnson. Naranda Naidu. Megan Nikita Naidu. Darshan Sayanth Nair. Senior Scholar Science, Valentina Nashetti. Frederick Zander Nell. Lisa Wangoon Ng. Nicole Lottan Ng. Henry Walter Frost Northcote. Senior Scholar Science, Tiffany Carol Oliver. Nalishma Devi O'Neill. Samuel Thomas O'Sullivan. Stacy Joan Oxnam. Caitlin Renee Marie Oyagawa. Ivy Vianca Salish Pavilion. Mandy Min Pan. Ui Tan Pan. Fiona Helen Panther. Joshua Gordon Parker. Alice Dane Cruz Pasco. Ashwin Patel. Dashid Vinay Chandra Patel. Devon Gopal Patel. Karishma Patel. Riddhi Dilip Kumar Patel. Vishesh P. Patel. Danielle Lace Patterson. Brianna Pierce. Benjamin Michael Pearson. Stephanie Jane Wayata Pemberton. Michaela Rose Petroff. Keyshan Logan Pillay. Pote Pongchaikul. Simranjot Kaur Punia. Jamie Ellen Powell. Haley Pragett. Annika Lee Kismet Prankert Goff. Jordan Timothy Prasad. Chelsea Ortega Price. Jeremy Douglas Price. Hamisha Priya. Morgan Elvis Sanford Pugh. Lucy Merrin Sarah Della Clarice Ray. Rainlish Raman. Pratiksha Roli Ramji. Sonia Minal Ranchod. Elizabeth Jane Rankin. George Cran Ransfield. Ajay Karthik Ravindran. James Dean Rawlings. Senior Scholar Science, Jeremy Matthew Stewart Rains. Senior Scholar Science, Michelle Louise Reeve. Lois Reeves. Jessica Sue Rehana. Lisa Sunita Rekraj. George Aaron Terence Revel. Neil Graham Richardson. Ellie Lynn Rickman. Christopher John Riddell. Tony Michelle Rickness. Brent Clive Rip. Laura Kate Roberts. Charlotte Lynn Durlow Robertson. Laura Bridget Robertson. Emma Christina Robinson. Brianna Constance Robson. Minchol Rowe. Robert Harrison Ross. Michael Corey Dean Roswell. Kane Leyland Rotherham. Ranita Danette Roy. Elliot Patrick Michael Ruddock. Samuel Alexander Russell. Jonathan Benjamin Lawrence Russell Webb. Taryn Lorraine Sabine Shaw. Ashniza Binti Sahadan. Utez Xerxes Sahir. Ratchikorn Sakulnak. Olivia Rose Salthouse. Oliver Henry Beaumont Sanders. Kevin Harland Saputra. Bernard Thomas Schilling. Julia Jalen C. Jerick de San Miguel Cimeros. Shadia Shaleen. Shabnam Sharifi. Ronel Sharma. Jenna Camille Sharp. Eli Scholl. Daniel Jacob Sheffield. Jin Cheng. Wei-Yin Karina Su. Alfred Ulasi Sifa. Ian Robert Simon Simpringham. Jessie Catherine Mary Sims Johns. Jasmeet Singh. Katen Carvin Singh. Satnam Singh. Ashna Medina Siraj. Danishan Raj Sivaragnanam. Zahidula Slimankeel. Anna Elizabeth Smith. Samuel Jeffrey Smith. Alana Judith Smythe. Garbal So. Dayang Song. Mireille Song. Bianca Claudia Staines. Catherine Charlotte Steele. Ellie Mackenzie Stevens. Kim Marie Stevens. Carla Stein. Tom Buckwell Stoner. Matthew Paul Sullivan. Brooke Amy Somerville. Mingzi Sun. Yan Yuan Sung. Jennifer April Sweeting. Pin Liang Tang. Jonathan Wilson Tate. Eleni Awoke Takila. Tamate James Tamatoa. Jack Tan. Iran Tao. Kevin Taishan Yang. Erin Wysom Taylor. James Samuel Chernikovsky. Megan Yi Wen Tay. Thomas Sanele Tele. William Tang. Beatrice Theobald. Paige Alicia Lovett Thomas. Katrina Frances Thompson. Christiana Jeanette Thompson. Ricky William Thompson. Otenaru Junior Toeloa Isara. Amber Essie Tognazzo. Kihon Tong. Matthew Caleb Tonkin Henwood. Monique Ruth Townsend. Kinson Tran. Amy Trin. Nina Tropina. Tao Ping Xiao. Ari Yingsing Sei. Nip Yan Sui. Gerald Simisi Lea Saituna Tui Malaya Leafano. Mayu Uda. Rika Andrea Asuncion Velador. Caleb Derek Van Bainen. Ruth Vanderhever. Richard Greg Van Der A. Natalie Ann Van Der Sand. Mark Martin Cornelius Van Kerkhoff. Theo Johan Van Noort. Harsha Sadashiva Vashisht. Burns Williamson Vaughan. Carmen Lara Venter. Ellen O'Neill Vincent. Tim Alexander von Arsen. Christina Elise Waldron. Jiali Wang. Yifan Wang. Xiaofan Wang. Katie Louise Ward Allen. Matthew Robert Waters. Courtney Maureen Watkins. Senior Scholar Science, Leighton Miles Watson. Angela Way. Rebecca Ellen West.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Alex McFarlane on viola, accompanied by Rosemary Barnes, will now perform Sonatensatz by Brahms. Thank you. Thank you, Alex and Rosemary, for that fantastic performance. Can I ask you to join with me in thanking Alex and Rosemary once more? By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Science, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I call upon an Associate Dean of the Faculty of Science, Mrs. Goldstone, to present further graduands in that faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Ellie Mae White. Shan Emma Wadavan. Reuben Thomas Wilkinson. Jordan Louise Wilson. Daniel Joseph William. Logan Zane John Williams. Joseph Michael Charles Wilson. Teresa Mary Wilton. Leah Jane Withers. Modigo Carla Witherington. Irene Sue Bo Wong. Calvin Kwan Yin Wong. Yuan Ning Wong. Matthew Anthony Wood. William Edward Peter Wood. Alana Marie Wiley. Kejin Zhao. Pam Yana Ranup. Ping Yu Yang. Julian Young. Lin Ling Zhong Yao. Cam Hong Yao. Li Fei Yi. Li Wen Yun. Xiao Yong Yun. Nicholas Brian Allen Young. Ding Wong. Chun Yin Yun. Kai Man Yun. Caroline Ann Yul. Aylin Sheng. Xun Xiang Sheng. Xiao Si Sheng. Chao Meng Sheng. Yang Sheng. Yu Bo Xiong. Bao Yu Xiao. Chao Xiao Xing. Xi Xiao Xing. Wendy Zhang. Xu Jinping. Yan Xiao Xu. Yifei Su. Renying Xiao. To the degree of Bachelor of Technology with First Class Honours, Patrick Gregory Bowen. Senior Scholar in Science, Ryan Murdoch-Hawker. Grace Yuan Lu. Senior Scholar in Science, Jingyong Lo. Yadong Wang. Michelle Chi Monyap. To the degree of Bachelor of Technology with Second Class Honours First Division, Samuel Allen Hitchman. To the degree of Bachelor of Technology with Second Class Honours Second Division, Gunit Kaur. Postgraduate Diploma in Forensic Science with Distinction, Adeline Lecoq. Devlin J. White. Postgraduate Diploma in Forensic Science with Merit, Kelly Lee Boris. Shireen Radhika Sharma. Postgraduate Diploma in Forensic Science, Kaveri Ramesh Singh Badora. Mark Anthony Brooks. Arishma Anarish Lata. Gael Marceline Putukonka. Jimatel Shalini Singh and a Bachelor of Science. Alicia Gavetta Toro. Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Distinction, Cassandra Jane Mark in Biological Sciences. Lilith Leaping in Statistics. Catherine Jean Seward in Environmental Science. Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Merit, Jenny Mai in Wine Science. Jessie Alana Mayhew in Wine Science. Amber Jean Mead in Wine Science. Rowanna Isabella Mowbray in Speech Science. Eleanor Christie Natris in Clinical Exercise Physiology. Sunil Pravita in Psychology. Shrida Kishore Rathi in Computer Science. Shivani Sethi in Sport and Exercise Science. Angela Lawrence Smith in Marine Science. Tatiana Valdez in Food Science. Stephen Lachlan Wallace in Biological Sciences. Rhiannon Elizabeth Webb in Psychology. Rachel Marie Tullia-West in Biomedical Science. Jonathan Simon Thomas Woodhead in Clinical Exercise Physiology. Reza Odex for Uravilsa Delgado in Environmental Management. Postgraduate Diploma in Science, Hilary Hoi Yan N in Food Science. Tishiana Federman de Oliveira in Marine Science. Brett Carmel Palmer in Biosecurity and Conservation. Shriya Narendra Patel in Biological Sciences. Prudence Mary Estelle Rain in Environmental Science. Amrit Pal Singh in Pharmacology. Delaney Ryan Smith in Clinical Exercise Physiology. Ji Tung in Statistics. Sambath Tung in Medical Statistics. Fianga Hilotu Mitawara Yukala Tupo in Chemistry. Samantha Yuri Watkins in Environmental Science. Jason Alistair Wells Lakeland in Environmental Science and a Bachelor in Science. Chen Young in Geographic Information Science. Roy Jin Young in Applied Mathematics. And a Bachelor of Science. Yifei Zhang in Psychology. Chancellor, I now call upon the Acting Dean of Science, Associate Professor Anson, to present further graduates.
To the degree of Bachelor of Science Honours with First Class Honours, Fajana Azleen Abdul Saip in Statistics. University Graduate Scholar Justine Lucy Atkins in Biological Sciences. Paul Bike in Chemistry. Wense Bai in Food Science and a Bachelor of Science. Thomas Niels Byrne in Biomedical Science. Harpreet Kaur Shahal in Chemistry. Andrew Chan in Chemistry. Jordan Brooke Charlton in Sport and Exercise Science. Chloe I. Cho in Chemistry. Yun Han Choi in Statistics. Kenneth James Clarkson in Mathematics and a Bachelor of Science. Kathleen Jessica Collier in Biological Sciences. Samuel James Davidson in Medicinal Chemistry and a Bachelor of Science. Courtney Jane Davey in Chemistry. Gabriel Angelo Agbayani de Guzman in Biomedical Science. Natalia Judeline de Sousa in Psychology and a Bachelor of Science. Andrew Stewart Estabrook in Medicinal Chemistry and a Bachelor of Science. Tiffany Shu Yu An Ng in Biomedical Science and a Bachelor of Science. Jennifer Yom in Biomedical Science and a Bachelor of Science. Madeline Mercer Fletcher in Biomedical Science. Tania Marie Faouk in Biomedical Science. Thomas Edward Freeman in Food Science. Michael Leonard Garalja in Biomedical Science and a Bachelor of Science. Jodi Ann Jing Ho in Medicinal Chemistry. Joshua Allen Homer in Medicinal Chemistry. Leroy Armstrong Hudson in Chemistry. Victoria Jane Jackson in Biomedical Science. Ju Yong Jiong in Medicinal Chemistry. Lillian Rosalie Jones in Geography. Sam Patrick Kavanagh in Computer Science. Joshua John Kirkpatrick in Biomedical Science. Thomas Andrew Langford in Food Science. Christopher Keith Arthur Lear in Biomedical Science. Ryoxi Lee in Food Science. Mugda Manda in Medical Statistics. Jacob William Martin in Chemistry. Sena Masood Ansari in Computer Science. Laurel Mae MacArthur in Psychology and a Bachelor of Science. Sarah Meidinger in Biomedical Science. Nurul Adiba Mood Rashid in Statistics. Cheyenne Maria Antonia Mueller in Chemistry. Upeksa Nandasena in Psychology. Nicola Marjorie Pete in Sport and Exercise Science. Nina Iftimova Peshava in Psychology. Tessa Mary Popey in Biomedical Science. Lena Hanel Ricola in Biological Sciences. Stephen Philip Rowland in Food Science. Daisy Alice Shepherd in Statistics. Raisha Ashina Sidhu in Biomedical Science. J. Jeffrey Satanto Tang in Food Science. Renique Chantal Tenhajian in Psychology. Cherie Tanya Tolemash in Medicinal Chemistry. Daniel Jonathan Townsend in Biological Sciences. Kanton Tabmongkong in Biological Sciences. Yuktibin Vyas in Biomedical Science. University Graduate Scholar Wesley Howard Webb in Biological Sciences. Rebecca Stephanie Westcott in Psychology. Daniel Jeremy Wilson in Chemistry. James Michael Wood in Medicinal Chemistry. Xiao Yang in Biomedical Science and a Bachelor of Science. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division. Neil Edward Bolton in Chemistry. Dylan James Brown in Physics and a Bachelor of Science. David Joseph Bunn in Food Science. Jeremy Chun Yin Chan in Physiology. Aidan Daniel Daly in Geography. Sharma Shiraski Manella Disanaki in Medicinal Chemistry. Dalen Charlene DeMello in Geography. Jared Mitchell Griffin in Pharmacology. Pratik Gupta in Computer Science and a Bachelor of Science. Paul Junior Harris in Mathematics. Melissa Ann Harrison in Geography. Marie Dawn Hawkins in Applied Mathematics. Richard Thomas Mogola Hopkins in Statistics and a Bachelor of Science. Shatin Jaisukla Shivanji in Sport and Exercise Science. Elizabeth Kate Judd in Psychology. Chongchun Lee in Geology. Finn William McClellan Elliott in Geography and a Bachelor of Science. Nahazwan Mohad Zain in Biological Sciences. Jasmine Frances Plows in Biomedical Science and a Bachelor of Science. Catherine Marcia Sheffer in Psychology and a Bachelor of Science. Reuben Murray White in Chemistry. Junxi Zeng in Statistics. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division. Jun Ma Cho in Biomedical Science and a Bachelor of Science. David Graham Elliott in Mathematics and a Bachelor of Science. Stephen Lee William Keaton in Physics and a Bachelor of Science. Spencer Magnus Arthur Charles Raymond in Geography. Jennifer Louise Stott in Chemistry. Simon Keith Whelan in Applied Mathematics. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies, Gavin Neil Jacobson in Food Safety. Sahar Jalali in Food Safety. Jenny Wong in Food Safety. Athena Tengzi Yuan in Food Safety. Feifei Zhao in Food Safety. To the degree of Master of Speech-Language Therapy Practice with First Class Honours, Emma Nicole Cook. To the degree of Master of Speech-Language Therapy Practice with Second Class Honours First Division, Grace Patricia Adams. Stacey Louise Bowater. Xing Yi Chai. Claire Frances Fui. Karen Marie Watson. To the degree of Master of Speech Language Therapy Practice with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Sabrina Mather. Jessica Louise McMillan. Renee Stephanie Taylor. Marie Walesi. Rosalinda Fay Wong. Suet Lee Yap.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Samuel John Drummond McKechnie in Statistics University Doctoral Scholar. Sam investigated methods to improve the development of a class of stock assessment models of salmon to better inform management of their fisheries. Victoria Chantal McClelland in Psychology. Victoria investigated the function of a brain structure called the hippocampus, examining its role in storing memories of imagined events. Nguyen Huang Minh in Computer Science. While investigating the theoretical and applied basis of web-based image processing and computer vision for 3D content creation, Min proposed a unique framework which, from a pair of 2D images, extracts 3D information for various applications. The developed web server hosts a 3D gallery, so far visited by more than 12,000 people, originating from more than 50 countries. Christina Joel Painting in Biological Sciences University Doctoral Scholar. Chrissy focused on the ecology and mating system of the New Zealand giraffe weevil, in particular determining the factors that led to the evolution of alternative mating tactics and weaponry in this species. This research contributed to current evolutionary and behavioural ecology theory, as well as highlighting giraffe weevils as a model species for field-based research. Mei Peng in psychology. Mei developed a unique method for measuring people's sensitivity to smell, which will contribute to our understanding of people's preferences towards consumer products. Mei. Ryan Martin Perry in psychology, university doctoral scholar. Ryan developed a new measure of social world views, how people perceive their social world, to better assess the cognitive processes that lead to prejudice. Matthew Keith Pine in marine science. Matthew measured the underwater sound generated in the sea by a variety of human activities, such as vessels and electrical generation turbines, and investigated some of the ecological impacts of this sound. The results of his research have had a significant impact on the manner in which underwater sound is managed in the marine environment. Georgina Martha Ray in Biological Sciences, University Doctoral Scholar. Georgina investigated the function of the dormancy-associated plant genes DRM1 and DRM2 in order to understand the molecular processes by which plants respond to their environments. Jaspaljeet Singh Ranjit Singh in computer science. Jaspaljeet developed and evaluated a patient-centred web-based telehealth system for the senior population. His research shows how to design a system that is ubiquitous, social, extendable by third parties, and accepted by potential users. Helen Elizabeth Reid in Geography, University Doctoral Scholar. Helen's research on the Tongariro River developed a multi-scalar framework which analysed variability in river processes and forms at the catchment scale. This framework presents a more coherent scientific platform to design river rehabilitation schemes which work with natural processes and the evolutionary trajectory of the system. Rhys Pierre Roberts in psychology. Rhys investigated how the brain stores visual information in working memory. He showed that visual features are stored independently of each other, and that visual working memory most likely relies on many of the same brain regions that are involved in visual perception. Megha Rajesh Shah in Biological Sciences. Megha investigated the properties, localisation and roles of two phosphate-binding proteins that occur in adhesive fibrils, which are characteristic of recent hospital isolates of pathogenic Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Paul Evan Shucksmith in Physics, University Doctoral Scholar. Paul investigated the uncertainty in radar and rain gauge measurements of rainfall due to the resolution of those observations. He then assessed how this uncertainty impacted applications of the data, including rainfall runoff modelling, flood prediction, and radar rain gauge correction, with the ultimate objective of his research being to improve flood forecasting. Colin Mengchen Tan in Biological Sciences. The fungus Botrytis cinerea causes serious losses in many horticultural crops. Colin's research investigated the possibility of using Botrytis virus X as a biological control agent of the fungus. Kiwi Tan in Biological Sciences. Key studies have contributed to an understanding of the potential roles of plant phytochemicals in reversing multi-drug resistance in cancer chemotherapy, in causing adverse food-drug interactions, and in improving the bioavailability of drugs and phytochemicals. Rong Ying Tang in Biological Sciences, University Doctoral Scholar. Lucia investigated a novel adenoviral vector as a vaccine for cancer therapy. Encouraging results from mouse studies and human blood cells generated by Lucia during her research highlighted the potential of this viral vector as a vaccine against cancer. Teresa Narwin Tor in Chemistry. Teresa focused on developing a novel marine anti-fouling coating to replace problematic organotin copper-based compounds and other environmentally hazardous materials that are currently used on underwater surfaces in the marine industry. Anne Tomlinson in Biological Sciences, University Doctoral Scholar. Anne's research on litter invertebrates assessed interactions between native and introduced species and their impact on ecosystem processes. She discovered that exotic millipedes were abundant in native forest remnants in Auckland and that they potentially accelerate nutrient cycling, leading to changes in the litter and soil environment. Yiqing Xu in Physics. Yiqing investigated some of the light field conversion mechanisms using optical fibres and fibre cavities and applied these mechanisms to improve the light power of fibre laser sources. Yang Shun in Biological Sciences. Young investigated the activity and membrane binding properties of an antimicrobial protein that is produced by the human parasite responsible for amoebic dysentery in order to better understand the disease and aid the development of therapeutic antibiotics. Leonardo Nicolas Zamora Allendez in Marine Science. Leonardo investigated a number of bottlenecks for the development of the commercial aquaculture of sea cucumbers in New Zealand, so solving major practical issues for the industry. and in absentia all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Science.
We are nearing the end of this formal part of the celebration. On behalf of the University, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. And while you are standing, this would be a good time for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieved their qualifications. Can you remain standing for a moment? This concludes this meeting of Council and Convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and award of diplomas. I now invite you all to stand and sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of the programme. Thank you.